Thank you, dear Chairman, and distinguished participants of this important event, which is in a big chain of events here in Lithuania. And I'm very glad that a very sustainable platform is here in this room. Probably we don't see so many distinguished nuclear people or related people with nuclear in our country, though we are a nuclear country for many years already, after we inherited the Ignalina nuclear power plant since Lithuanian independence in 1990. We have different possibilities to develop our nuclear program further on after the closure of both units of Ignalina nuclear power plant. So reality and plans for our new build in former site of Ignalina nuclear power plant, Visaginas nuclear power plant project. I'm representing the Lithuanian energy utility, Lietuvos Energija, and I'm responsible for the development of this project. Just recently I was also leading the whole utility in our country. As I said already, Lithuania used to be the most exporter of electricity in the region, as we had two units of 1,300 megawatts in Ignalina nuclear power plant, and both units have been shut down in end of 2004 and 2009. Since that, in year 2010, we became the most importer of electricity in the region, and not only in the region, but in fact in whole European Union. So in year 2010, 11, 12, and in this year, we are importing more than 60% of electricity. This is absolutely unacceptable. Though we have quite good facilities in central part of our country, but unfortunately we cannot manage with the prices in this electricity zone. And data is from Eurostat for 2010, 11 more or less is the same. For today, probably we have a little bit less of imports because of the situation with our grid in the neighboring countries and the heating season, which is starting now. If we can go, I'm sorry. We have a very well developed electricity system, and Lithuania was probably one of very well developed electricity network and the generation capacities in former Soviet Union, especially in this western part of former Soviet Union. And this is a snapshot of power system balance in the corner, in the left corner. So we see that import is prevailing. This is summer June picture of our transmission system operator, and in fact, our supply in 2012, which is not very different from today's picture, we see that imports from third countries, so-called not European Union countries, it means mainly Russian generators, is making about 50%, and Latvia and Estonia is supplying for us about 15-18% of electricity. So one quarter is made by our fossil plants, which are located in the central part of our country. We have a huge hydro accumulative plant of almost 900 megawatts, and we have installed capacity of 1,800 megawatts in Elektrėnai city, which is between two biggest cities, not so far from Vilnius, 50 kilometers located plant. Hydro capacity in the country is very small, which is less than 150 megawatts. So you see the flows, which are coming from Latvian part, and also Kaliningrad is mainly supplying our Russian electricity. So this is the situation, and In fact, European Union is assisting three Baltic countries to build links towards the Nord Pool area. So is there a possibility to have a very big laser? All right. So we have one link in operation between Estonia and Finland. Another one of 650 megawatts is under construction. So totally will be 1,000 megawatts connection to Finland. Another DC link, one of the very long DC links connecting Sweden and Lithuania, 700 megawatts line is under construction, and connection to Poland, back-to-back asynchronous link, 500 plus 500 megawatts is under construction. So our three countries will be quite well connected, newly connected to European network, though definitely we have quite many challenges in here. So the price zones in Scandinavian countries helped us a little bit with prices, though this week especially we had a very big spike. We had the price for electricity for 200 euros per megawatt hour. So it's unusual for us because average price is about 45 euros. In this area. So, but that's because of season, because of our connections with the Russian and also with Russians mainly, and definitely because of local production, which is the most expensive generation in fossil fuel plant. The newest CCGT plant can produce electricity with the price about close to 100 megawatts. So reality is very difficult, in fact, for our utilities. I'm sorry. And so rationale for the project in the region, nuclear in former plant, in former site of Ignalina nuclear power plant is very obvious. And we have done during the last 6-7 years, in fact, all work has been started to be done in 2007 when our three prime ministers, in fact 2006, three prime ministers agreed to build a regional power plant to start with one unit. And later on the company was established in our utility a lot of work has been done since that, and we have recent decisions or support from International Atomic Energy Agency. Our site has been evaluated. Then environmental impact assessment, which is now on very high note in our neighboring countries, in Kaliningrad area of Russia and a Belarusian plant, which is very recently popped up in very close neighborhood of 50 kilometers from the place where you are sitting now, in very nice woods. And we completed a lot of development work. One of very important things is that the tender, international tender for selection of a strategic investor, had a very great success. We had several proposals, and Hitachi General Electric Nuclear Energy has been selected as the technology provider and investor of 20% of the total investment. And we also obtained the European Commission's opinion on the plant according to Euratom Treaty Article 43. So definitely the regulatory environment in the country concerning the nuclear safety and the development of the project have been improved, and we in fact rewrite all legal acts concerning this. So more than 70 legal acts have been adapted. And as the plant is on the mainland, we have more than 500 kilometers from the Baltic Sea to the Visagina site. So this transportation route for very heavy items have been planned and have been selected. So all arrangements, preliminary at least, for radioactive waste management have been done, and different kind of related work also have been developed. The project structure itself, it is not very simple because, as I said, the project is of regional origin. So there are participants from Latvia, from Estonia, Lithuania. So we have the strategic investor who is also having the shares. At this time, the distribution on the shares is 2038-2022. So those utilities are also, like Lithuanian utility, owned by the state. So there are three state-owned companies and private entity, Hitachi as investor, and Hitachi GE Nuclear Energy as the technology provider. And the technology, I didn't mention, it's advanced boiling water reactor. And our company should build a project company who should be responsible for the construction and organization of all the work, and also should be receiver of the concession from our state. So Lithuanian government, as a project hosting country, country's owner, has additional duties, starting from legislation, then policy setting, also interaction with European Commission, definitely tax and customs regime, because it is three countries taking part. So we have also many discussions with the DG competition. So there is quite complex thing, but it's very, I think, important for European nuclear, especially for smaller countries. If we can succeed with that project, then there can be a very good breakthrough for the small economies to go with the joint project. And what is very important also to mention, that our regulatory body of Lithuanian nuclear regulator have been strengthened, and improvement have been achieved also during recent years. So we have experienced regulator, and definitely the licensing process is a new challenge. But anyway, I think that we are on very, very good good path for the development. The site itself, as I said, it is on the site of former nuclear power plant with two units, one and two. We selected two sites, one here noticed like one and three. This is on the biggest lake in our country, with the neighborhood of Latvian territories over there, and to the eastern part, we have Belarusian territory. So the site is really convenient, because we have inlets and outlets very close to selected site, because this site has been elected. It belongs to, we rented as a company the site. So the accession routes and railways and other means are ready for the development. So it really fits very well for a new technology. So as I said, selected technologies, 1350 megawatt electric general capacity, ABWR reactor. So additional measures post Fukushima has been already implemented in newly built plants in Japan, and they are definitely already introduced to the proposal. Project timeline. As I said, we started 2007, and we are on preparatory activities path. as I said, it's not the easiest project for different reasons, and as a very huge investment project for our not big economy is a challenge. So politically, is the project which has a lot of discussions and different political opinions on that. But I should say that step by step we go further, and especially recent activities show again good trends towards the further development of the project. We should step to design, construction, and commissioning path, because last year our parliament initiated the concession agreement with Hitachi, and contractor Hitachi is selected. So we should finally provide the concession to the project company. So in fact, we should establish the project company in coming months and start this step of our timeline. So the estimated time of NPP operation is 60 years, then definitely should come the decommission. So preparatory works, in fact, are done. Now we should go to licensing and detail planning activities. And in fact, Hitachi, GE Nuclear Energy people, those who are related to construction and to nuclear technology itself, are in fact ready to step in. And as you know, probably that Hitachi also acquired two sites in United Kingdom with the goal to supply there up to 6 units of ABWR reactors. So we can be in very good situation with the fleet of advanced boiling water reactors in this part of Europe. I should add that not only technical activities are done in our country, human research development is quite well ongoing. So there are nuclear energy physicists, engineers. We have our Lithuanian Energy Institute, who is working very well. So there are also regional initiatives of research and development, where General Electric, Hitachi Alliance, Hitachi itself, universities and research institutions from our neighboring countries, from Poland, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, are in, and we are also working for regional nuclear center of excellence here. So there are estimations of what the construction of such plant can bring to Lithuanian economy, impact to GDP and for state budgets, and also new working places. So that is more or less clear. What is as of today? Last year, exactly 1 year ago, 1 year and 3 days, 4 days, in fact, 14th of October, the advisory referendum took place in our country. So we had not very good results for that. And now the politicians are thinking how this result should be treated, because it's advisory referendum. And we have been doing a lot of additional work. So very recent document, all investors prepared the position paper about the present situation. All parties signed the document and submitted to our government at the end of September this year. And now we have very active week, by the way. Probably you are also fitting in very good with our political movements at the moment. And it is planned that the decision of the continuity of the project should be done during this month or coming months, how we move further with the activities or active development of the project. So, and really I'm welcoming very much your platform here, Sustainable Nuclear Energy technology activities, and hope that our country also can be a part of this movement and really add value to your work. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, so please.